Good morning. My name is Russell Stanners, Chief Executive of Vodafone here in New Zealand. Today's a very special day for Vodafone when we look to talk about our plans for the future in the city of Christchurch. A special welcome to the Honourable Jerry Brownrie, Honourable Stephen Joyce, Honourable Amy Adams, and the Mayor of the City, Liam Denzel. Big welcome to all of you. Oh, and Nikki Wagner, sorry. My apologies. Honourable, yes. Thank you very much. Look, and a special also welcome to our customers and partners, you know, because without you, we wouldn't be doing what we're doing here in Christchurch. Before we go on to talk about the future, just a quick reflection on the past for Vodafone here and its various guises in Christchurch. Clearly back in early 2000, our first customer for Clear Communications was the Trust Bank of Canterbury that brought the business down to Christchurch. We began laying fibre and copper throughout the city. We also, in 2002, under Telstra Saturn, started to drive out fibre coax networks, the forerunner of the UFB networks of today, and indeed started to deliver digital TV here in Christchurch, which we're very proud of. Another key thing we did was to ensure the security of communication supply into Christchurch by building the only aqua submarine cable that goes out up the coast, connects us with our northern counterparts and beyond to ensure that we have continuity of communications. In 1994, we started as Bell South, built the first cell tower in Papua Nui out there, and now we have several hundreds right throughout the region here providing not only 3G communications but 4G communications to all of us here in the city. And when we look at what we've done in here, we've been very pleased to be involved in building infrastructure out throughout the city, but also in what we did after the events of the earthquake to make sure that our networks were there, available, were quickly rebuilt and delivered the support to all of the people here and the business alike as part of what we needed to do there. And after that, in around about 2011, we also partnered with the government with our Vodafone Foundation for the Vodafone Foundation Christchurch Fund, which is a fund to actually help both small businesses and communities to re-establish their businesses and their facilities here in Christchurch. And obviously in 2012, we're delighted to bring all those companies together under the Vodafone brand with our acquisition of Telstra Clear. So today what we wanted to do was to talk about our future. If we look at our business today here in Christchurch, we're spread across three main locations. We have our premises out by the airport, which is a technology premises, which is great. It's all in good shape and we'll continue on. We have a temporary facility in Riccarton Road for part of our people, actually a converted Les Mills gym, which brings some interesting dimensions to the building and working environment. And we also have our building in Hereford Street, which was badly damaged but still functioning through the earthquake, which is very close to the planned future stadium. So we need to move out of there. And so what we're delighted to announce is that we'll be moving into a new purpose-built building in the Innovation Precinct. So let's just have a look at that building. This building will be in the 213 to 221 Tuam Street, right in the heart of the Innovation Precinct in the CBD. It's about three blocks from here, very close to major transport links, retail, and I've been told there's a few good cafes nearby, which is fantastic for our people. The building is a 8,000 square metre facility, four levels with lots of open space and natural light. Initially, we'll have 350 people, but it's designed for growth and can have up to 900 people here in Christchurch. It represents for us an investment of $50 million in the rebuild of Christchurch, and hopefully we can be the kind of anchor tenant to really set the Innovation Precinct alight and take it forward. Obviously, as you'd expect, it's a five-star green building and is built to the highest standards in terms of the building code. So that's our new premises, which will be completed in early 2016 for not only our staff, but obviously our partners and our customers here in the heart of the Innovation Precinct. So that's one little view there. And we have another little view there. And as has been reported in the papers, that's a large electronic billboard on the side of the building with the wrong sports team. Trust me, we'll get that little omission fixed as we go forward. So it's a delight to be investing in Christchurch and continue the innovation that we've been part of our brand since we came to New Zealand. And speaking of innovation, when we think about this building, yeah, obviously we want to have a great building, open, collaborative building, a green building built to the highest standards. But for us, it's all about the working environment inside the building. And in 2005 in Auckland with our venue facility, we set a new standard in what can be done by moving to an open plan, collaborative, mobile-enabled workspace. And that was before the advent of smartphones and tablets. What we intend to do with our building here is to take a big step forward, to set a new standard for what we think the future working environment will be like in a fibre-enabled, video-enabled, smartphone, smart tablet world. All of those capabilities exist today, but never before have we put them all together in a complete working environment. That's the challenge for the technology team, to make sure that on the day we open that building, we have that environment available to complement the structure that we built and be known as the Vodafone Christchurch Centre here in the city of Christchurch. We're very excited about it. Innovation is what we're all about. And believe me, those capabilities will set a new standard in what customers, partners and our staff can do with our technology. But that's not all we want to do here in Christchurch. When we think about innovation, then what we look to do as part of this project is to bring what we know globally as the Vodafone Zone Incubation Hub here to the city of Christchurch. We have five of these around the world today, obviously in Silicon Valley. We have one in Milan. We have one in London, Cairo, Dusseldorf. I think I've named them all. That is a key part of how we do innovation. What is it all about? It's providing a facility for anywhere between 10 and 20 startups to be part of the environment that's in that building there, to utilise the technology, the collaboration you can get when you bring them together and have them co-located with our technical staff. And really importantly, what we'll be looking to do is to shrink down a copy of our production network, both the fibre networks, the mobile networks, into a technology playpen that's available for innovators and startups to create solutions in a fibre and mobile world. Hopefully solutions are not only useful for businesses here in New Zealand and for Vodafone, but solutions which potentially can be exported around the world. That's the model we've used elsewhere. That's a model we're bringing here to New Zealand, and we're bringing it here in partnership with Callaghan Innovation, who'll be looking to support us and co-partner in bringing that to the city along with the city of Christchurch here, so we can tap into what is undoubtedly a wide, rich vein of technology-enabled entrepreneurs in the greater city of Christchurch. Something we've always known that's there, something we've always wanted to do. This is the building as the catalyst for us to take this forward. So it's a really exciting concept, the zone, which over the next 2 years we'll look to flesh out with our partners, get it ready so that we can launch it and bring it into being in 2016. So that's what I wanted to share with you this morning. It's a major commitment by Vodafone here in the city of Christchurch, one we feel very excited about doing. We're looking to make a step change in terms of the working environment for our employees with the technology we showed there. And we're looking to partner with the city and with government to bring forward this incubation hub, the Vodafone Zone, to enable the best of what we think we can with the entrepreneurs and the technology companies here in Christchurch. So with that, I thank you for your time. And now I'd like to hand over to the Honourable Jerry Branley.
Well, thank you, Russell. Can I also acknowledge parliamentary colleagues who are here, Honourable Stephen Joyce, Honourable Amy Adams, Honourable Nikki Wagner, and of course the Mayor of Christchurch, the Honourable Leanne Dalzell. This is a very important occasion, I think, for the city. We're going to have lots of these important occasions, but there's a couple of things I'd just like to say. None of these things happen just overnight. Things like this do take a bit of time. So once we put out the CBD plan a while ago and designated that area as an innovation precinct, a whole lot of work had to be done by a lot of people to try and make things happen in that space. And we're going to see further announcements about what can be achieved there over the months ahead. But I just want to acknowledge, firstly, that you know, it's taken a lot of cooperation. The former landowner, for example, has told me that Rabobank and Kiwi Bank had to come to the party for a while to make things happen. But more importantly, for Russell and his team, international capital that you're seeing invested here doesn't just descend on some sort of charitable basis. There has to be a business case made for it. And Russell, I want to thank you very much for the advocacies that you've taken on behalf of the city. I'm sure you've done it on very sound business basis. But nonetheless, to compete in a global market as you do for your part of the Vodafone business and succeed, I think it's a great tribute to you and a great privilege for us to be the beneficiaries of that investment. Can I also challenge Jazzmax and I think Calder Stewart, a great South Island company, to try and beat that deadline, so we might see it a little sooner than that early 2016. I like doing that because everyone asks me why isn't it going fast enough, so I like to turn it back on people and say, well, how about making it go a bit faster? I think the other part of this, of course, is that you have your consents through the council, and I know that they'll work very well to get the building consent part done as well. So a very, very important day. Congratulations to the team who pulled it together, Patrick Fontaine and others who were part of that. Mrs. Winder, I forgot your first name. I'm sorry. Rachel. Rachel reminded me earlier that I taught her husband some years ago, which is not the sort of thing you like to hear when you imagine you're still a young man. But I really do want to congratulate the team for what they've done. I think it's great. And Carl Smith from not only Gough, Gough and Homer, but also Canterbury Rugby Union is quite happy to talk to you about that billboard on the side there. I know that they're always looking for new sponsors, and is that something I can announce now on your behalf? It's worth a try. So to all of you who are here who've had part of it, can I just say congratulations? Can I acknowledge Roger Sutton and Warwick Isaac, who are here also? Warwick's team's done a great deal of work to try and hold this precinct together. It's looking very, very good. And once again, Russell, thank you and congratulations for the achievement and the announcement today. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Jerry. It was a little bit of an effort to get the group to invest in Christchurch. One of the hardest questions was they asked me, is there going to be another earthquake? And dumb question, right? It's like, but we were able to convince them that it would be a great building and we've got to do that. Now I'd like to invite the Honourable Stephen Joyce to say a few words. Stephen.
Thank you, Russell. I'd like to acknowledge my parliamentary colleagues, all the honorees, the honourables. Also, Honourable Leanne Dalziel, ladies and gentlemen, it's great to have the opportunity to be here today. I'm standing here speaking to you as Minister of Science and Innovation, and I'm a passionate believer in the precinct that this project is catalysing. I'd like to congratulate Vodafone on locating its South Island headquarters. In fact, I think we heard an expanded South Island headquarters, and its New Zealand-based zone incubator, which is only one of six across the world here in the Christchurch Innovation Precinct. And that's a great endorsement of the value and contribution the Innovation Precinct will make to New Zealand's growing innovation system. And I believe it's an endorsement of the innovation that we see in this city of innovation. And there's plenty of companies around that can demonstrate that as well. The government, of course, is very committed to the rebuild here in Christchurch. And the Innovation Precinct is an important key element of not just the rebuild of the Central Business District, but also the rebuild and strengthening of the Christchurch economy. Encouraging a strong Canterbury economy means more jobs and higher incomes. And the Christchurch economy is supported by a strong base of high-tech companies whose products and services are in demand internationally, alongside research expertise in ICT and engineering. And that's exemplified by the successes of companies like Jade Software, Arans Geo, SLI Systems, and I could go on and list a huge list. And of course, we also have not far from here the Epic Centre, which has been supported by New Zealand Trade and Enterprise and MBIE over the last few years, and there's some tremendous companies in there as well. Of course, New Zealand economy generally, and of course Christchurch, has its challenges. Aside from earthquakes, we're a long way from world markets, and we compete with cities across Asia Pacific, including Sydney, Melbourne, Singapore, and so on. So Kiwi innovation and fostering that innovation is hugely important. It does drive our success. Our ability to think outside the box is part of our history, and that's been sparked by our location in the world. Our distance from other countries means we had to come up with stuff, and we are doing so very successfully. The findings in the 2013 Technology Investment Network report, the TIN 100 report, highlight that. The top 100 tech companies had revenues of $7.3 billion, up 4% year on year, and 7% employment growth. And a number of those companies are based here in the city. If you have useful innovation, you have a ready market, you will have access to capital, you'll be able to hire the skilled people, you'll be able to use resources more efficiently, and you'll be able to access the infrastructure to sell internationally. And it's innovation that drives all of that, and the business growth agenda is very supportive of the importance of innovation. So, a network of innovation hubs is a key part of our business growth agenda. They encourage idea sharing and generation, enable firms to bridge the gaps between concept and production, and have a higher level of innovation. The Canterbury Rebuild provides an opportunity to create a unique precinct, which will provide a stimulating, enabling, and dynamic environment that fosters ideas, fosters a culture of technology-based, talented people and businesses. And that is the vision for the Christchurch Innovation Precinct. So Vodafone's decision to locate here is a clear indication and endorsement that the market has confidence in the vision for the precinct. And I'm very pleased to see it unfold. And I've had a few discussions with Russell over the last few months and had the blow-by-blow account of his discussion with his international bosses and the competition that occurs within Vodafone for capital amongst the different countries. And he really has delivered on this, not only for his own company, but also for Christchurch. There's a number of other things that are going to occur alongside of this. For example, the government will be supporting the development of an innovation hub to accommodate startups within the precinct. This will offer a lower rent option for this for smaller companies that are getting going, and that's important to have alongside the bigger companies. Callaghan Innovation and NZ Trade and Enterprise will also locate their business-facing services in the innovation precinct. But the big one, though, is skills. New Zealand's ICT sector is currently experiencing very rapid growth. Many ICT firms can't find people with the ICT skills that they need to support firm growth. Universities have increased the amount of investment they're placing in ICT skills, but the growth so far, I think they're up about 20% in 2 years, is not meeting demand. So the budget this year allocated a further $29 million over 4 years for ICT training. So the second announcement today is I'm announcing the establishment of 3 ICT graduate schools, one in Auckland, one in Wellington, and one in Christchurch, which will deliver industry-focused education and research that builds connections between tertiary education and key ICT firms. I'm delighted to announce that the Christchurch Innovation Precinct will be the first confirmed location to host the Christchurch ICT Graduate School. The government will shortly launch a tender which will allow interested providers to bid to provide the school here in the precinct. We anticipate the graduate schools across the country supporting 350 or 360 students per year for 1 year postgraduate courses that will then see them directly into employment into our ICT sector. This is an initiative whose time has truly come, and I think it's a very important part of the innovation precinct here in Christchurch. Minister Brownlee and I are also delighted to release the Innovation Precinct Spatial Framework today, which sets the high-level urban design principles of the area and illustrates how buildings and spaces can work to encourage innovation and innovative activity. There's a whole tremendous array of photographs and discussion in the framework, which many of the developers in the area are already familiar with. But placing that in the public domain today, together alongside with the announcement of Vodafone and the ICT Graduate School, will start to give, I think, a strong flavour for what we're seeking with the Innovation Precinct. So it's a great opportunity for the city, and frankly, it's a great opportunity for the country. Christchurch, of course, is New Zealand's second largest city. We know that the difficulties that everybody's experienced through the earthquakes and the recovery period from that, but we really are in a case of now of not just about renewal and rebuild, but actually building things that are better and more exciting than what we had before. And that is the opportunity that this innovation precinct brings, the opportunity to gather together smart, innovative people in the areas of ICT, design, CPIT just around the corner, and a graduate school in the precinct. I mean, that really is the beginning of something that's pretty special, not just for the city, but for this country. So can I congratulate everybody in the room, as Jerry said, who's done the hard yards to bring this all together to this point. It always looks easy from the outside, but there's plenty that has to go on to make it all happen. I think the vision that you are showing in bringing together not just this project, but the other projects that are now being talked about, will be something that you can look back on in 20 or 30 years' time and say, hey, I actually got involved and made this precinct happen, and it's been great for the city. Thank you very, very much for your time today.
Thank you, Minister, and I'd also echo what was said about the support and cooperation from all of the people involved in the City of Christchurch. Now, I'd like one last person to invite to the stage, the Honourable Amy Adams, who's our Minister of Communications, who's a key part of our industry, so perhaps to share a few thoughts. Amy.
Well, good morning, Russell. Thank you for the invitation to be here. I can obviously acknowledge my colleagues and Mayor Leanne Dalziel, who's playing a critical role in making the city come back better than ever. Look, I just wanted to say a couple of quick things, and the first is obviously as a Cantabrian, to thank Vodafone for the confidence that they're showing in our city and in our region. Quite apart from the earthquakes, actually, Canterbury has had a really strong technology sector for a long time. And one of the comments I often make to the sector is if they need to do anything, it's just fly the flag a little bit more. Because actually, not many people are aware that IT and ICT is our third biggest export sector in this country. So behind dairy and tourism, ICT is our third biggest. And a lot of that industry is focused here in Christchurch, and it's something that, as we've heard from other speakers, we can really capitalise on as part of the rebuild. So it's tremendously exciting to have the announcements today around the Innovation Precinct, and particularly to have Vodafone's commitment to Christchurch and the sector here. The second thing I wanted to say is simply to congratulate Russell and the team on some of what we saw in his presentation about the way this building will work. I've spent a bit of time in Vodafone's building in Auckland, which has a similar sort of look and feel to it, and I can tell you it's a really vibrant, exciting, positive place to be, and I know that that's going to create that same sense here. But in some ways, the more exciting bit is to hear some of the add-ons that Russell mentioned. So as the Minister of ICT, it's my job to make sure we roll out ultra-fast broadband and the rural broadband initiative and the 4G networks. And that's all really exciting, but it's only exciting if people take the opportunity to do things differently off the back of it. So what we're rolling out and building is very much a foundation enabling technology. But it's when businesses start to think, okay, how can we use this to do things differently and to do things better that we really see the benefits. And Russell, I just want to congratulate you on some of those initiatives that you mentioned in the bill today. And actually, I've got no doubt that we'll look back and 5, 10, 20 years' time, and across the city and across the country, we'll all be doing things in ways that we can't even imagine today. But what we're seeing here now is the forerunner of that, and it's an incredibly important part of the development of ICT in our future, and of course that the rebuild of Christchurch, as ministers have said, not only putting back what we had, but putting back something far, far better. So look, I just wanted to add my voice of congratulations to Vodafone and to endorse that the words of the speakers have gone before me. Thanks very much.